Welcome back, future nurses. So this is our sixth key area of responsibility with its core competencies of nursing in the Philippines. So the sixth one is professional development, and this key area includes core competencies of identifying personal needs for education and pursuing the goals of being a professional, and we are also expected to participate, to engage, to join our professional organizations and their activities, and in a larger context we should contribute professionally to our to our communities. So in the community also we are upheld to present a professional image and positive attitude. So we are also likewise expected to carry this professionalism in our own workplaces or institutions. So let's present the different core competencies. So core competency number one, we should be able to identify our own learning needs. Okay, so as a professional, we should do this always, maybe regularly as six months or yearly, based on our career path. So identify your needs, your aspirations, your goals as a professional. So you verbalize in your institution your strengths, your weaknesses, limitations, determine and also communicate your personal and professional goals and aspirations for your own professional growth. Okay, and maybe your institution later on can contribute to this career path or professional growth that you are aspiring. Then number two, pursues continuing education. I know I've mentioned this in our previous video lecture that once you are a professional, the more that you're going to study, the more that you need to update yourself. You're not already basing from the school's curriculum, but your own curriculum, if I may say it that way. So you participate in formal and non-formal educations, in activities that will increase your knowledge, will add up to your experience, and likewise you should apply your learned information for the improvement of care, especially if you were sent by your institution to such formal or non-formal education. For example, you were asked to join a conference or a seminar, and what you have learned in that activity, you should bring it back to your institution, and hoping that would be a contribution to the improvement of performance or care or improvement of the whole institution. And third, a nurse should get involved in professional organizations and civic activities. Okay. So once you become a nurse, you are expected to join our organizational professional organization, or your APO, which I know this was discussed to you in your fundamentals, accredited professional organization for nurses in the Philippines. We have PNA, the Philippine Nurses Association. Okay. So we participate actively in that professional, social, civic, and religious activities, whether you're an organizer or a member or any other roles that you have, whether it's paid or unpaid. The point here is getting yourself engaged in organizations and civic activities. and maintain membership to professional organizations, support activities related to nursing and health issues. In our case, the Philippine Nurses Association, we renew our membership every year. That's the minimum one, the most basic one. But you can also apply for a membership which is already lifetime. Then it's based on your age bracket. Okay. The number four projects a professional image of a nurse. I know this has been mentioned several times already. So how would you manifest this? One is demonstrate good manners and well conduct at all times. Dresses appropriately. Well, we have our uniforms, especially if you're in the hospital, you carry that, you know, that immaculate, as they describe, immaculately white, even males. And then for the ladies, of course, the one of our representations, the nurse's cup, right? It's like a crown that you're wearing. And demonstrates congruence of words and actions. Okay, so what you say, you do. What you you preach, you practice, and behaves appropriately at all times. At all times, okay? Whether you're in work or outside work, wherever you are, whether you're in the institution that you're working or even outside. Okay, the word there is all. Okay, so be challenging, but I know as a future nurse you would do this because this is your aspiration. Okay, you visualize yourself as a professional nurse, whether here or in abroad. You wake up in the morning, you look at the mirror, then imagine yourself wearing your nurse's uniform. Then number five, possesses a positive attitude towards change and criticism. Okay, so I hope it's a constructive criticism. Okay, and it's a criticism which will further improve you. Okay, so and the thing here is, how would you react? How would you view the criticism? Okay, so indicators in this competency is one, listen to suggestions and recommendations, especially from colleagues, from supervisors, and tries new strategies or approaches based on what is taught to you, based on what is adapted by the institution, based on what you learn. Okay? Adapts to changes willingly, okay? Especially right now, in this time of new normal, there are many changes. So I hope one of your attributes already as a nurse is, or as a nursing student, is adaptability. Okay, ability to adapt, to be flexible, to adjust in this fast-changing society environment. Then number six, performs function according to professional standards. Okay, so as a professional, we have guidelines to follow, we have standards to follow, we have protocols, rules, name it, okay, and the like. We must observe this, we must abide with this legislations, protocols, SOPs, and what is important also here as a professional is you have to practice maybe regular self-assessment, self-evaluation, or even self-reflection for the values, the attitude that you are learning, okay? And know what is right and wrong with regards to your professional standards. So indicators are assess your own performance and gains, standards of practice, set attainable objectives to enhance nursing knowledge and skills. Okay, explains current nursing practices when situations call for it. So I think as you go along with your careers, especially for those who are on the their fifth, fourth, sixth, fourth to sixth year, somehow you've been thinking of upgrading yourselves, promoting yourselves, so that's good. But before that, you assess first yourself, your performance, your competencies, okay? And as mentioned earlier, you verbalize, okay, your aspirations in your career, and say it in a nice way, subtle manner, and communicate always. And there is no problem with that, okay? As long as you do not step on onto others' own growth, and you always seek for wisdom and prayers, okay? So this is our key area of responsibility, professional development. So as I mentioned earlier, practice every day. Maybe in the morning when you wake up, you look in the mirror, visualize yourself as a professional nurse wearing white or any uniform of what institution you want to be employed later on, and start manifesting an image of a professional nurse, because you will be someday. Okay, thank you. So see you on the next video lecture for the rest of this career of responsibilities. This is again Sir Emil, hoping and praying that you become a nurse, okay? Online nurse educator. Thank you.